Hey there, folks. Psychotic comedian for 167. I didn't think I'd be in today, but I know you're probably happy that I'm here, so let's go and do. Yeah. Well, UPTV, I remember one time years ago, I think it was just out of high school, I was laying down in bed by this one girl named Ginger, and she looks at me and says, Kevin, how big does that thing get? Get your mind out of the gutter, UPTV. She was talking about my ego. Jeez. All right. Well, though, seriously, it might be longer than this, but last time I was at a bar, sad cases go to bar. Last time I was at a bar in town here was probably 10 years ago, and the only reason I went was to play some mind games with the women, because let's face it, they play games with, I'm not going to even be there for them to play games, but I went there to play, mess with them a little bit. Two of them would come up to me and go, hey, handsome, how you doing? I go, ladies, look at all these good-looking guys in here, and you're talking to me? You know, go talk to them. They said, well, okay. And the bartender overheard the conversation and said, sir, if you finish your Pepsi, could you please leave? You're making everyone look like an ass but yourself. I said, well, it's a bar, isn't it, Kevin? All right. Everyone was probably drunk besides me. Well, the other day I was walking in the mall one time, and just to get out of the house, get a little exercise, I was a little cabin fever. Well, I walked by Victoria's Secret. I don't go in there much, three times a week. But I walked by Victoria's Secret, Kevin, and I saw a guy, a chubby guy, kind of balding, and he had a pair of panties in his mouth, and he was barking like a dog. It was my former case manager at the mental health center, Kevin. God, I knew he was a loose cannon. All right. UPTV, do I know where I'm at right now? No. Do I know what day it is? No. But hey, Kevin, I'm just going to have fun with it. Come on, everyone have a great time. Well, yeah. If you've been following my show, you know who my first wife was. I met her at a bordello, you know, a whorehouse, and I went in to get service one Friday night. And you know who she? Yeah, she was the infamous daytime hooker, Sherry Donuts. And I go, and I was married to her. She goes, "These guys have to pay for it. You get it for free, you big stud, Paul." All right, that's a little bit of commentary. I don't want to see it sound like I'm the voice of men all over the world, but I just say, you know, I wanted to apologize to the guys in their 20s and 30s. I personally really have stopped chasing women and going after them because I got some peace of mind with my hobbies and job I do and stuff. But I say if you're in your 20s, I don't want some 23-year-old saying to give up totally just because of what I said, but or 30. But I say when you get around my age, approaching 50, I'm 49, it's time to start a garden or something, isn't it, Kevin? All right. I live in a little bit of a rough neighborhood, Kevin. Sorry your show's starting a little late, but I just got back from the hospital. I took two bullets in the shoulder by a gang member named Dr. Pieperstein. So I apologize for a late arrival. Yeah. Well, I'm back into the martial arts. This is really calming a bit. But I told Jason at least 3 days a week I want to do 30 minutes of martial arts, 30 minutes of the gym, two paintings, and do the guitar, which would be a challenge for me. But one time I was in karate class with my instructor. It's been a while, years ago. And one guy says, you know who Ron Jeremy is. Probably most guys know who this guy is. But he goes, you do look like Paul Ron. You do look like Ron Jeremy, Paul. And the instructor, who was as much of a character as I was, he goes, yeah, when Paul's changing clothes in a locker room, Steve, you hit the lights. All right. Well, here's something you probably don't want to say on a date if you want to see the girl again. Heather, there's plenty of handsome guys out there that would love to go out with you. I mean, just look around here. And you're going out with me? Huh? You'll find your Prince Charming one of these days. I was her date. It's probably not a good thing, is it? I'm going to end with a song, Kevin. How about that? This is Def Leppard, Rock of Ages. So Kevin hasn't heard me sing yet. So let me just get this up. Oh, I know where it's at.
Oi, 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 oi.
Glad Globin. All right. There's something to say. Yeah. It's kind of a burnout. Yeah. Fade away. Oh, right. Ow. Gonna start a fire. Come on. Rise up, gather round. Rock this place to the ground. Burn it up, let's go for broke. Watch the night go up in smoke. Lock on. Lock on, drive me crazier. No serenade, no fire brigade, just a pyromania. Come on, what do you want? What do you want? I want rock and roll. Yes, I do. Long live rock and roll. Set the fight, gonna blow like dynamite. I don't care if it takes all night, gonna take this town alive. Come on. What do you want? What do you want? I want rock and roll. All right. Long live rock and roll. Yeah. Rock of ages. Rock of ages. Still rolling. Rock and rolling. Rock of ages. Rock of ages. Still rolling. Rolling. Got the power, got the glory. You say you need it, and if you need it, say yeah. Listen to me, I'm burning, burning. Got the fire, I know for sure. There ain't no cure. The beam is on fire. Hit the floor. Burn down the road, yeah. What do you want? What do you want? I want rock and roll. You betcha. Long live rock and roll. Rock of ages, rock of ages, still rolling, rock and rolling, rock of ages, rock of ages, still rolling, keep it rolling. We got the fire, got the glory, just say you need it, and if you need it, say yeah. Say yeah! We're gonna rock this damn place down. Mm-hmm. Down to the ground. You lit the match, there it goes. Well, I bared myself on that one. Okay. That's the end of the show, folks. I'd like to thank so much Kevin today. I told Kevin that he becomes a famous independent filmmaker to put me one in one of his films. Who knows? But Kevin so much today, and Jason Leggett today, and also Jake Shoemaker. And let's see. This is the psychotic comedian bidding you adieu. I think that the show was pretty good. I kind of slid. I already said that line. See ya.